Mm-hmm.
I'm sure we all have those hidden talents that no one is aware of, right? That was the first time I was seeing the dance myself, and I'm so proud of him. I said, this day I was definitely going to try not to get emotional because, you know, my days are numbered. But anyway, the last part of our program, we want to talk about Ellison as the humanitarian. I mean, most of you already know that it doesn't even have to take for me to talk about community service because you probably see the Ellison in your relationship with him. With, you know, it's his temperament. I mean, he's one of the kindest, and I'm not just saying this because he's my child, but I see his interaction with his friends. He goes hard, he sacrifices himself. Sometimes I have to tell him, I'm like, okay, it's okay to be selfish a little, you know. You gotta remember not to put yourself out there where you care about someone, but you also gotta remember this is still your life, where you love hard, but again, no one is gonna love you more than you, meaning you have to walk that journey alone, regardless of what your decisions are, but your relationships, yes, you cherish them, but in a sense, like I said before, you know, I can't say enough about him, so I'm not going to, and I'm going to let the village speak now. So on behalf of his community service, I'm going to ask if Naisha T. Gibbs comes forward. And she has been instrumental in just the many programs that Ellison has participated in, and I'm sure she will share with you some of those things at this time. Thank you.
Good evening to the extraordinary members of Ellison Cain Grant's Great Village. I am Naisha T. Gibbs, the president of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Iota Alpha Omega Chapter, located in the Mid-Hudson Valley, and I am affectionately known to Ellison as Miss Naisha. As a member of this elite village, I'm honored to share a few words with you, and most importantly, with Ellison Cain Grant, our man-child, a scholar, an athlete, and a humanitarian. To be young, gifted, and black, Ellison Cain Grant has begun to stamp the world with his super awesomeness and his humbleness. Ellison Cain Grant leaves his imprint on everything and everyone in his life. Ellison Cain Grant is destined for greatness. To be young, gifted, and black. I met Ellison a few years ago through his mother, my sorority sister, and ever since I have been blessed to learn about Ellison's scholastic and athletic achievements and witnessed his humanitarian efforts. Each time I see Ellison, I am always greeted with that smile that illuminates the world and a warm embrace. I always return the megawatt smile and warm hug, but I always look him in the eyes and engage him with a brief word of encouragement. As a mother of four young men, I know the journey that our young men are destined for, and I am firm in my faith that God has purposed each of them for greatness in their lives. He strategically places members of each village in areas to encourage, uplift, shape, mold, and guide these young men. We must continue to encourage them, engage them individually and collectively, and we must let our boys, and our girls too, know that we see them, we hear them, and we are here for them. To be young, gifted, and black. Ellison, your mother, father, sister, and brother are proud of you. Your AKA aunties are proud of you. Everyone is proud of you. Your life, like a track race, continues with this next race. And like all the other practices and ultimate races, there have been mountains, valleys, rough places, smooth places, joy and pain, celebrations and defeat, and you have persevered. Continue to persevere. Overcome any hurdles with the speed and precision that you know all too well. During your race, where the track is straight, stay focused, cruise, Conserve your energy, keep your pace with those alongside you. But oh, Ellison, when the bend, you know, the curve in the track, when it's evident and you can see the finish line, find your strength. Keep your head up, stay focused, dig deep, push, accelerate, and soar. You got this race. You will win. I leave you with the song lyrics to Be Young, Gifted, and Black, written by Weldon Irvin in 1969 and sung by Nina Simone in memory of our great Lorraine Hansberry. And if any of you are unfamiliar with these people, I recommend that you Google them. To be young, gifted, and black. Oh, what a lovely, precious dream. To be young, gifted, and black. Open your heart to what I mean. In the whole world, you know, there are billions of boys and girls who are young, gifted, and black, and that's a fact. Young, gifted, and black, we must begin to tell our young. There's a world waiting for you. This is a quest that's just begun. When you feel really low, yeah, there's a great truth you should know. When you're young, gifted, and black, your soul's intact. Young, gifted, and black, how I long to know the truth. There are times when I look back and I'm haunted by my youth. Oh, but my joy of today is that we can be all proud to say, to be young, gifted, and black is where it's at. Thank you. And on behalf of Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, Iota Alpha Omega Chapter, here is a gift to assist you in your pursuit to higher education. God bless you, Ellison.
Some of the other community leaders in the room, and I don't want to put anybody on the spot, but I definitely, like I said before, would all just, in that same vein, would the ladies of Alpha Kappa Alpha please stand, my sorority sisters. Thank you so much for being a part of Ellison's life, and I especially want to point out, sorry, Shelly, because she came all the way from New Jersey. She's a part of my undergraduate chapter. Thank you so much. In the room, we also have a member of Alpha Phi Alpha fraternity. Can you please stand? Ellison was a part of the Leadership Development Institute program, right?
That's correct.
And he also received their scholarship award and book award. So thank you. Thank you again. The room, because again, I can't do this without you. Please stand, and I know Felicia came all the way from Long Island, and she's known Ellison since he was born. She's behind the camera now, and she's literally thrusting that upon us, so thank you. Girlfriends, where are you? Sister friends, where are you? I can't even tell you all about how much I love and appreciate your support. Thank you for being here. Antoinette, you already know. You already know how I feel about you. So I am very, those who know me know I'm always trying to engage everyone in the room. I love interacting. So in my hand, I'm going to have everyone in the room, those who did not speak, have an opportunity to give well wishes. You just have to read what's on the paper. It's just that simple. But it's encouragement for us all. And these are things that I always like to be inspirational. Because again, yes, we're here to celebrate Ellison, but we're also here, you should always center yourself around positivity, people who uplift you. It's not only your parents that help you to get to where you are, we're talking about the village. And I'm sure all of you have people in your lives who you consider your village, whether it's your coaches, you know, it doesn't matter. Your teachers, it takes all of us. I mean, even for myself at, I won't say my, well, you know what, at 46, it doesn't matter what age you are. It's all about you developing Black excellence, that excellence within yourself, that you know you have that confidence to do anything that you put your mind to. So at this time, I'm gonna pass the mic, and I'll start off excellence, since I just spoke about it. No one leave the room, no. Excellence. Every job is a self-portrait of the person who did it. Autograph your work with excellence.
Amen.
Passion, a journey of 1,000 miles, begins with a single step.
That's right.
Change is life-giving. It helps us grow into someone greater than we already are.
Collaborate. To stand apart from the competition, you must stand together as a team.
Commitment, extraordinary energy, concentrated power, and sheer will is complete. This will be the potent mix required to break barriers and reach the pinnacle of success.
Commitment.
Drive. It is not always those with the longest drive who win the game. It is those who have the drive and determination to stay the course.
Be the bridge. Problems become opportunities when the right people come together.
Success is a journey, not a destination.
Yes.
She was about to skip me. Dare to soar. Your attitude almost always determines your altitude in life.
Integrity. Do what you know is right always. With commitment to your deepest convictions, you stand tall against time and tide.
Stay focused, and you'll find that the best is yet to come.
Vision. Go as far as you can see. You will then have the vision to go even further. Leadership. The supreme quality for leadership is unquestionable integrity. Without it, no real success is possible.
Adventure. Never be afraid to find new roads to travel, new horizons to explore, and new dreams to call your home.
Journey. No matter where life takes you, never lose sight of where you came from.
Wisdom. The lessons of the past provide the path to the future.
Endurance. Go over, go under, go around, or go through, but never give up. Never give up. Innovation. The best way to predict the future is to create it. Achievement. Shoot for the moon. Even if you miss, you'll land among the stars. Thank you. Is there anyone else who would like to say anything but did not speak because I ran out of cards? But...
I'd like to say something to our brother that's going to be released, and I say this in the vein that if anybody's seen the movie Roots, your first one or the second one, and you see that scene where they're going to remove the children, Kunta Kinte, and the men, they're going to take them and they're going to segregate them from the rest of the village and That's when that time period comes when they are transformed to their manhood. Okay? And this is that period of time where you're going to be given the opportunity to develop an Afrocentric identity that intellectually, as your mom had brought out, you're a martial artist, just as much as I am. This is the time where the scholar becomes the warrior, becomes the monk, in the ancient tradition of the warrior monks. And so I say before you, you know, I honor you. I honor the contributions and the blessings that were bestowed upon you. Okay, I support you, and I will continue to support you and support the other graduates here. But as she said, there's a special, I should say, target on your back for black men. And I'm just a college dropout, okay? I'll put it that way. But at the same time, first thing is when you get to college, retain your identity. Don't let anybody else compromise your integrity. Keep that identity with you because it's brought you this far, okay? You're gonna need it to take you to the next level before you hit the corporate world. Number two, I already gave you a hint earlier. Don't work for the Department of Defense because they're gonna take the best of what you have and use it against the global population. Use it for good. Use that brain for goodness, okay? Use that brain for science that's going to bless the lives of future generations. Number three, leave a legacy. Okay, something that you won't be ashamed of. Leave a legacy that will bless the lives of others. Okay, number four, okay, don't, you know, when you go to college, don't think about the girls in the sororities. Think about a future wife. Notice the difference. You're past the girl stage now, okay? Now it's time for a wife because that wife will become the queen that will help to support you. That's what you want. I want a girlfriend. You'll be saying girlfriend when you go to college, okay? Number six, okay? Always, always put you before the university. Don't ever project the university as, oh, the university is me. No, you are better than the university. They were there before you even came, and they're gonna be there after you leave. So keep what you have, okay? The university is just a stepping stone. It's a team you're on until you move on to the next team and the higher challenges, okay? You know, so keep that in mind. Remember where these universities came from. That's another speech, another lecture, okay? Number seven, okay? As a martial artist, acquire the skill set, okay, that you're gonna need to adapt to any situation for victory. And I say the skill set, okay? Certain situations, you see you got a boxer, you gotta adapt to that boxer style. See a Muay Thai, you gotta adapt to that Muay Thai style, okay? You see the Jiu-Jitsu, okay? Incorporate these elements, just like the elements here, I noticed, this element table here. Incorporate that, okay? Don't just become one-dimensional. All right? Number eight, get beyond just the education. Just like she said, the Googling. We shouldn't have to Google a Ring Hansberry. That's in our blood. That's what we are. Read the Ring Hansberry. Okay? Keep the tradition. Lewis Latimer, keep that tradition. Okay? George Washington Carver, keep that tradition of the famous African-American scientists who've come to pass and who've made contributions to civilization. Okay, keep that tradition. Think about that. How am I gonna go higher? Number nine, just like a martial artist, okay, you know, you go in a room and you always size everybody up because, you know, anybody could be a threat. That's the same thing, okay? People may think you are a threat, and I say there's a black man, okay? You know, keep your intelligence, keep it at a level by which, you know, other people, they may see you as a threat, go even higher. Go stronger, just like your mom said, go harder. Okay, you either go hard or you go home. A lot of suicides on college campuses, especially at the tech campuses. There was an excellent article in Atlantic Magazine. It says, do Ivy League schools, okay, contaminate the students? A lot of the kids you're gonna be competing against, they have mommies and daddies and they're in the network, they're in the system. Oh, get them a job, no problem. Hey, it's not like that for us, unless you continue to network with our fraternities and our sororities that historically have always held us up, okay? And number 10, my last one, okay? Keep your sense of humor. You're gonna need it. Okay, it's not that serious. Okay, out there. Okay, as long as you know what your level of confidence, not cockiness, but your confidence is, you're going to be as successful as God has blessed and gifted you to be. Okay? Amen.
Thank you so much. At this time,
and you're done.
Your family will like to make a tribute to you. We're going to start with your younger brother.
You are my brother, my older brother, now ready to take on the world, as you should. You are going to do great, very great.
Amen.
You are an adult now, and even though it will be sad to see you go, you will be starting a new next chapter of your life. And the impact you made on everyone you met in the first 18 years of your life will never be forgotten. Thank you.
He just celebrated his moving up ceremony, so he's transitioning this September to ninth grade to high school. He's also a scholar. He has like a 97-98 grade point average. And next we have baby girl Sterling, his sister.
Most of you guys know me as Elsa's little sister, or just that girl who looks like Elsa. My name is Sterling, and well, Hannibal just made a poem or whatever. Mine's more like a story, so. Okay. I've known Elsa for a little over 14 years, and my birthday is next week. June 30th, remember?
Yeah.
Yeah.